invite the first group to join the stage with such an interesting topic about association of Helicobacter pylori infection and new onset diabetes, a systematic review and meta-analysis of cohort studies, presented by Mr. Pakhin Paramiraksa.
Good afternoon, honored judges, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Pakhin Paramirak from the Faculty of Medicine, Waseda Hospital, Naomi Thalajilat University, Thailand. And I would like to start the oral presentation now. The Association of Helicobacter Pylori Infection and New Onset Diabetes, a systematic review and meta-analysis of cohort study. First of all, let's start with the background. Diabetes, the most prevalent and morbid chronic disease, posing substantial clinical and public health burden. Globally, 1 from 11 adults have diabetes, with 90% is the type 2 diabetes, and Asia is the epicenter of this global epidemic. There are multiple risk factors for diabetes, and gastric infection has been reported as being one of the possible risk factors. And now let's emphasize more on the gastric infection. The most common gastric infection is Helicobacter pylori, a gram-negative bacterium. In North European and North American population, about 1/3 of adults are still infected, whereas South and East Europe, South America and Asia, the prevalence is as high as 50%. As you have stated, the area with high H. pylori infection prevalence tend to have high prevalence of diabetes as well. Several studies have substantiated the fact that H. pylori infection was significantly higher in diabetic patients compared to the control group. Several studies have suggested H. pylori infection may increase risk of diabetes, possibly via inflammatory and immune response. However, there were inconsistency among studies whether H. pylori is one of the risk factors. We realized that there were systematic review and meta-analysis of observational, cross-sectional, and case-control study, but the study design of include study have restricted the determination of causality. To the best of our knowledge, there was no systematic review and meta-analysis of the cohort study, which enabled the evaluation of causal association, and thus we conduct a systematic review and meta-analysis of cohort study to estimate the causal association and pool effect. Let's move to the methodology part. First, we conduct a systematic review following the Cochrane Library and PRISMA guideline, and our database include PubMed, Scopus, Embed, and MedAchieve. We conduct a comprehensive search to identify the relevant study from inception to October 2022. All the process of screening, data extraction, and links by assessment were independently conducted by 2 reviewers. In case of consensus required, a 3rd reviewer will be consulted. The keywords are as shown on the slide, and we modify search term according to specific database as shown in the supplementary slide. The inclusion criteria include study design of cohort study and study that provide data with H. pylori infection without diabetes at baseline. Exclusion criteria include observational study without control group and study that does not report the H. pylori infection rate, and so on. The figure on the left shows the PRISMA flowchart diagram. After the removal of duplicate study, we obtained 1,720 studies, and after exclude according to the ineligibility criteria, we obtained 7 studies. Of the 7 studies, we conduct by an assessment using Newcastle and Ottawa scale, then finally conduct a meta-analysis for the eligible study. The table of characteristics show the result from systematic review. 7 studies involving 25,144 individuals comprising of population from Italy, Taiwan, US, Korea, and China. 4 of 7 were eligible for meta-analysis comprising of 23,473 participants. The reason that we do not include 3 studies, 2 reporting odd ratio, and 1 reporting risk ratio is that the number is not sufficient to conduct a meta-analysis. The figure show the result from the RefMan program, and the other one show the forest plot. Reporting pool estimate of hazard ratio 1.16 with I-square 78%, indicating that there was no statistical significant association with high heterogeneity. The lower figure show the result from the final plot, indicating low risk of publication bias. And now let's turn to the discussion. The proposed mechanism for relationship is explained via inflammatory and immune response. And as you can see that the I square is as high as 38%, indicating that there were inconsistency among inclusion study, and this could explain why the variation of method of H. pylori detection, potential covariable study design implemented, and time of observational that vary in each study. The explanation for discrepancy result with other study is due to the fact that we include only cohort study. The strength of our study is that, to the best of our knowledge, this is the first meta-analysis of cohort study and result from final plot indicate low risk of publication by us. However, we have the limitation and suggestion due to the limit number of available cohort study. In the future, if there were more cohort study, we recommend to conduct an update systematic review and meta-analysis and further study and need to investigate detailed mechanism and potential application for the finding to guide diabetic screening and treatment strategy. In conclusion, this meta-analysis revealed no association between H. pylori infection and diabetes, and H. pylori could mediate the onset of gastric atrophy and gastritis, which has been reported to be strongly associated with diabetes, and thus H. pylori eradication therapy may not necessary to prevent diabetes in patients without any indication of high-risk gastrointestinal disease. And H. pylori screening should be concerned for the following indication. First, diabetic patient with long-term use of acid suppressant drugs. And second, patient with the indication of high-risk gastrointestinal disease. And finally, I would like to thank you for giving me opportunity and for your undivided attention. Thank you.
Thank you. That's very educational.
Do our judges have any comments or any questions?
Because the heterogeneity is quite high, 78%, right? Did you explore why the heterogeneity was that high? Is it because of any factor that you will find?
We realized the high heterogeneity. We do not perform the subgroup analysis, but however, we perform the final plot that indicating low risk of bias, and we explore the source of heterogeneity, and in part it's due to the fact that the difference of time that follow the onset of outcome. Second is the variation of the HP detection, something like use of urate rate test or serology test, and finally is the design of the difference of the study design is study.
Possibly you can do sensitivity analysis on your result.
Can you repeat the question, please?
Possibly you can do sensitivity analysis on your result to check whether your result will be the same or not, whether when you drop some of the study.
Oh, yeah. Thanks very much. This is a point that we will continue to further study.
Thank you. Are there any more questions from our judges in both on-site and online?
I ask another thing about quality, the quality or that you assess of the study with Newcastle Ottawa scale, and what were the results?
All right, we conduct the by assessment with Newcastle Ottawa scale, and we conduct according to the form with two independent reviewers, and then we share the result to obtain the result. As you can show in the characteristic table on slide 6, we have shown the NOS scale that we assess for each study. Yes.
Is it high quality or is it moderate or low quality?
In our most study, most of the study have good quality and only one that have low quality. Yes.
Thank you. Are there any more questions from our judges?
Uh, What is your recommendation for the further study if they would like to explore the same issue with you? Because it's like you didn't find the significance from the meta-analysis, right?
Right. We recommend to conduct the study on the pathway that how H. pylori infection may induce diabetes, and it may be probably why the cytokine and hormonal effect, and this could recommend for the screening for diabetes.
Thank you.